Hi, it's Corinne, and today I am going to do a tour of my scrapbook room. I've been asked in the past to do a tour, and I don't know what I have to offer as far as organization, but I know I enjoy watching them, so I thought I would do one. So my room is a standard 10 by 12, I believe, room, and I don't have a ton of floor space because I have a lot of furniture in here. I'll try my best to make this as least shaky as possible. I'm not using a tripod. So as you walk in my room, let me close the door. Sorry, I'll try and go slow. On the back of my door, I have one of those shoe organizers. We used it on a cruise. Someone had given us the advice that because you don't have a lot of room in your bathroom on a cruise to use one of those. I believe I got it at either Home Depot or Walmart. And now after that, I use it for my punches, which works out great. So I don't have a ton of punches. I have the ones that I tend to use over and over. I have some EK Success and some Martha Stewart McGill punches as well. Down there I have some burlap, some bling, and some random lace. Over here I just have a little shelf with a jar that my sister had given me and just a few things that are special to me. I also have my Xyron Create a Sticker and my little light plate cover. My friend Claudia gave it to me. Thank you, Claudia. So behind my door, I have just, I like to hang up some random layouts that are special to me, but I have a couple of baskets that I keep my Tim Holtz binder rings in, some grunge board, some gesso, my Mod Podge, just kind of odds and ends things. Here I have some Tim Holtz tissue tape, some straws, some Cosmo Cricut ephemera, some saw crafters, wood shapes, and some Heidi Swap hearts and embellishments. I have some glitter tape, my Angel Craft Podge, some Liquitex, some extra cameo blades, and then those there are some doilies. I also have a pegboard up. On the pegboard I keep, as you can see, just kind of random things. I have quite a few Alpha stickers there and there. I really need to go through those. I have some Tim Holtz clipboard clips. I have some glassine bags. I have some pearls and just random things. So it's just kind of easy to flip through and see what I need or want to use. On the side here, I also have another pegboard where I have some basic gray brads and journal cards, envelopes. Here I have some clock kit and then some ephemera. I have more stickers, word stickers, flower stickers. Whoops. Journal stickers, things like that. Here I have some Tim Holtz tickets and journaling tickets. I keep dropping things. So then over here I have, let me show you these first. I have three of these baskets and these hold my Wild Orchid Craft products. These are Walmart brand, the Mainstay rolling basket. You find them in the laundry section. I paid $12 for them and I love them. Again, I keep all my Wild Orchid Craft stuff in them, so I'm able to just roll them right next to my desk when I'm working on something. They're very, very light, so they roll very easily. And even though it may not look like it, it is organized. I have all my red flowers down there, roses, things like that, and deeper colors. Then I have my wild roses, cottage roses, open roses on that. Here I have the smaller size, and then here I have the really small size, the 10-15 millimeter in different colors. And then Wild Orchid Crafts also has these mixed frames. I love them, so I keep all those right here. They also have the 3D stickers, So these are easy to just kind of flip through. Over here on this cart, let me pull it out. Like I said, they're really, really light, easy to move. So over here on this cart, I have little baskets to kind of help keep things separated. And I have these new pretty flory flowers. I love these. Those are there. And then my hip rosebuds, my rosebuds, my tulips, my sweetheart blossoms, Cosmo daisies, different small ones like that. Then I have my chrysanthemums all on this. And then the bottom is some poinsettias, some poppies, and gardenias. And then on this one here, I have my embellishments. I like to keep them, if I can, in this, in one of these. If they don't fit in that, I just keep them in a basket on the side here. And then I have my stamens and berry clusters. I have pearls and some leaves back there, some pearl trim. And then here I have the larger open type roses. And then at the bottom, I keep my white roses and summer blooms. And on the side, I have just a large binding clip. They have these wood cutouts. I love these. So they're really easy to keep organized like that, and I can cut pieces from them. I can take the whole thing off or just kind of go through it. So again, these are really easy to just kind of roll next to where my desk is and kind of go through everything. But they do take up a little bit of floor space, so let me get them on my room for the rest of the tour. Okay, so over here I have an IKEA shelf, and on the top there I have my 6x6 pads. I have a couple 8x8 and A4 pads as well. Here I keep all my solid papers. Here I keep my 12x12 paper pads. Right there are some 8x8 solids. I just use some book holders to hold that up. And on the bottom are just extra paper pads that don't fit where they go, where I keep them. And then I have some thread down there and my little decorative scissors carousel. I don't use this very often, or use them very often, but I love it, so I keep it in here. Also, it's good when I have like my little niece come over to let her use them. So more specifically, I keep my browns, meaning my crafts, my black, and my white in this section. And then the rest are just solid, either paper packs of solid colors or a specific brand. I keep them separated. And then, like I said, these are my colors. I have some, I think, 8.5x15 size black paper. Here I keep my stencils. So I have them in a folder here. And then this here are my small alphabet stickers, so I keep them separated, easier to kind of flip through. And then my paper pads are sort of in order. I have all the DCWV together, I have my Heidi Swap ones together. Just by different manufacturers, my Making Memory pads together. And then at the end, I have random ones separated. Here I have, this one is just kind of random. I have some Heidi Swap memory files, quite a few of them. I have my Snap paper packs, a couple of them. And then the rest from here are all organized by themes, I guess. So I have like polka dot, all my polka dot paper. I have flowered paper, retro, baby, so it's kind of easy to flip through. And then that brings us over to this shelving system here. This is also an IKEA shelf. I bought both of those from a friend of mine that was moving, and I love these shelves. So on the top, I just have some completed projects. I have a gumball machine that's been sitting there about 1.5 years that I keep meaning to alter. Here I have some more paper packs. Right here I have some Eyelets and Brads. Those are some blank journals. And in this black one I have a lot of Disney stuff and then some random loose leaf papers. And then here I have some paper packs. And then I have some random stuff here. Let me get a little closer. So I keep my Brads and Eyelets in these containers. This, like I said, I have a lot of Disney stuff. And then I have just some loose leaf papers that I've had for a long time. I try to use them. So these are just miscellaneous. Here are my specialty packs, like some Cartabella, pink paisley, things like that. And then this is where I keep my glitter paper, my clear cardstock, I keep my watercolor paper, I keep foil and sticky back canvas, and it's separated in here as well. Here's the smash book that I'm currently working on, some journal books that I'm currently working on. And these are upcycled post office boxes that my husband cut for me. I put, as you can see, decorative paper on the front of them. And then this, I have some graphic 45 papers. And then in here I have catalogs. And I also keep my tags, things like that, in little Ziploc bags along with the paper collection. So down here, those are just a couple of projects that I've worked on. And here I have these baskets that I keep all my dies and my stamps in. I just reorganized these with the Avery L bags. I'm really happy with these bags. I got them from Amazon and I just labeled them. I didn't want to use my Dymo label, so I just wrote on them, added a piece of paper in the center, and I keep a front and back. So these are really great. The bigger ones that don't fit, I just have them in the back here, and then I have some extra bags. Here's the bags here if you're interested. So these are easy to just bring right to my desk and go through them. I did that with the stamps as well. And if they have coordinating dies, I keep the coordinating dies in with them. So I did all my stamps, the larger ones back here that won't close, but I still kept them in there. And then the really large ones, I just keep in the back if they don't fit. And then on the side, I have a little bag for smaller ones that I can easily grab. So this works really well for me. Then down here in these cabinets, here are some completed scrapbooks or scrapbooks I'm currently working on. I have some layouts up there that I need to put in. So I'll show you these drawers in just a moment. Here I have my Mod Podge clear acrylic. I have lots of spray paints back there. I have another one of those baskets that go with the baskets there. That I keep my paper bags in. I have some extra paper bags there, my laminator. And then I have a little Lazy Susan that holds my different types of crackle medium and sprays and wood finish, things like that. Down at the bottom is my light box and also a cropper hopper that I'll have to show you here what that is. And that box on the bottom is just an Anna Griffin box. It's really pretty. And this is a box that I use too when I'm spraying anything. I use that. So here is this cropper hopper. I keep all my photos. This is back in the day when I used to print all my photos out. Now, most of them, I just print out what I'm planning on scrapbooking, and the rest are either on my computer or a zip drive file. But I have them all organized in these little clear envelopes, and these are great. And I have them labeled, so if I'm looking for a very specific photo, it's very easy for me to find. I have either dates or very specific labels of what's in there. And this holds a ton of photos. This thing is so heavy I can barely lift it. And let me just show you, it has another side to it. Let me show you quickly what that is. So on this side is just for larger photos. It has it comes with a really large envelope type thing. And that just holds my larger photos, anything larger than 4x6. 8x10 photos, things like that. So that stays down there. And then on each side of this shelves are hanging shelves. I just have some completed projects. I have some Sizzix embossing plates, some Hobby Lobby envelopes and notebooks. I bought a ton of notebooks. These are from the dollar store for a project that I had, and these are leftover ones. I have my embossing folders right here, and a few of these Sizzix dies or Tim Holtz dies. I have some liquid pearls and stickles there. On this side here, I like to keep some trims and fibers that are really long. I just come over here and cut off what I need. And then on that side, it's a little hard to see too, see it. But up there I have a sewing kit that was my grandmother's. I have some coasters for altering, some storage containers, dominoes, and then quite a few of these containers that have jewelry making things in them. Things I don't use that often. Some beads, things like that. So here on the side of the closet, I know it's a little hard to see, I have another one of those shoe organizers, and then these are just a closet organizer. I have some things I don't use very often. I have my transparencies and labels. I have some paint cans to alter, my paper crimpers, things like that. Down here I have a magazine holder with tons of catalogs and books in it that I like. I have some folders. That box back there is a bunch of three-ring folders. That's for my glue gun. I have a lunchbox to alter, some pipe cleaners, some perler beads, just odds and ends stuff. Here's some like extra organizing things. And then up there I have a few things that I want to alter. I know it's hard to see. I have my clay pasta machine for clay. And then here on the side, trying to go a little bit slower, I have a serger that was my mother-in-law's right down there. And then this box or bag, I should say, is a bunch of Christmas stuff. Sprays and pine cones and little ornaments. So when I'm working on something Christmas, I like to pull this out here as well. Also have some Halloween and fall items up here. So to this side of my closet, at the very top, I have some pots for a project. I have a bunch of completed scrapbook albums, and those were when I was into covering my own books, so they're all random scrapbooks completed. Here as well, these are all completed books, several smash books. I love going through those. That's a shelf that my husband had put up there for me. And then I have some things over here. These are mostly, all this stuff is to alter. So I have a bunch of canvases. I have some unused scrapbook albums back there. I have, as you can see, a cigar box, just quite a bit of stuff for altering. So I have some wooden things. I have Graphics 45 staples box. I have a blank album, some mason jars, some boxes that I like to alter at times. And then in these little drawers I have a bunch of laces, doilies. Here is my entire collection of wooden stamps. I don't have a lot of them. I've gone through them and destashed them quite a while ago, but these, I think I'm going to take them off the wooden blocks because these are some of my favorites, so I definitely want to keep these. Another drawer of just boxes, some frames, things like that, and then some more jars and some cans. Down here I have a bunch of pictures that I've recently printed out that I'm planning on either smashbooking or scrapbooking. And then I have candle holders, some coffee mugs that I like to alter, clothespins, some book boxes, things like that. Over here I have a large Cricut mat. I have a bag full of photos and ephemera from a Mexico trip that I need to put in an album. And then this dresser drawer here I love. So the top, I just have tissue paper. Here I have a bunch of tool. The next drawer as well is a bunch of tool. Sorry, it's going a little blurry there. And the last drawer is all my acrylic paints. So that is my closet. And also I didn't show you into this. Nothing too exciting, but these drawers here, I have some foam brushes and wooden frames, things like that. Again, some more random wooden stuff. I really need to go through this here, but some wooden items. And some doorknobs for mini albums, things like that. Here I have some jewelry making supplies and quite a few of these $1.50 frames from Michaels. So that brings us over here to my mid part of my room, my making memory station. I have some completed projects up there, excuse me. This little guy is something that my mom had made me. I hold little thumbtacks in it, and it sort of matches, sorry, I'm trying to go slow. This over here, my mom had made me. I don't have many things from her, so this is pretty special. And it's hung on a handmade hanger that my grandma hung it on, signed on the back from my mom. So let me go back over here. So up at the top there, I have some Adirondack inks. I have some diamond dust. I have a bunch of Martha Stewart flocking and glitters. I have my distress glitters here, some random glitters. I have all my Nuvo drops. Behind that, I have some storage containers with things that I hardly ever use. And then I have some Recollections flowers, some more glitter and Nuvo drops. Again, some more glitter over here, and then some ribbon. Down here I have my Lindy Stamp Gang sprays and Heidi Swap color shines, a few Adirondack daubers along with some distress paint. That's a microphone, and then that back there is a container full of pom-poms, and then I have some paints that I was using for a project there. That's a nail polish station holder, plastic acrylic holder. So back behind here are these making memory little plastic containers. Again, it's things I don't use very often. My Nuvo drops I'm loving though. I use those all the time. So here I have a work table that I borrowed from my sister and just never gave it back. So that's perfect because it's directly behind where I sit. So I keep my Cameo on there, which is perfect. I can just roll my chair over there and work on stuff. I have my printer. I have it covered from dust. So I have that under there. I have my sewing machine right there, which works out well because I can bring it right up to this workstation. Or if I move some stuff, I can set it up here. And my husband put a light up here for me to make it a little bit easier so I can work on, I usually stand and sew anyways. And then I'm going to show you while I'm on this side, my desk is a computer desk that my husband surprised me with probably 15 years ago. I used to have my scrapbook section in the corner of my master bedroom, so this desk was perfect because it holds so much stuff. But on the side of it there is a bookshelf right there, so I keep some copy paper, some little photo albums. That yellow box is some organza trim. So here's that yellow box. Again, it's right behind where I sit, so it's easy to grab. I have my quite a few bits and pieces of organza trimming. And then that blue box that sits next to my printer is my Wild Orchid Craft laces and organza trimming. So again, super easy for me to get to and flip through. And then this also sits in that little bookshelf. I have everything labeled. These are, I've had it for a long time. I don't tend to use them that often, but I do still use them for certain projects, but it's really old. But I do have everything labeled by, I have school, 4th of July, birthday, Baby. And there are a lot of the, here's Christmas, a lot of like the Jolie stickers and random stickers. Flowers, I have little boy. So that is just kept right there in that, behind my desk. So that's the side of my desk there. And then on my desk, I have this little cabinet. On the top there, I have these cute little cupcake things. They hold little Scrabble pieces in them. And then inside here, I keep my post-it notes, my double-sided tape, foam tape, things like that, my ATG tape, a hair clip, and some thread. And then I have some metal pieces in here, little frames and things like that. Here I have my carousel by Making Memories. I love this. This I reach for all the time. I have scissors, my craft knife, my pickup sticks, some pens, pencils, my glue stick, my paper piercer, my Cricut spatula that I use for my Cameo, some extra glue, my rulers, my little adhesive remover. Here I have some foam squares, some Scotch Quick Dry in a fine line bottle, my Glossy Accents E6000, my scraper for my mat, Cameo mat, my corner rounder, some brushes for when I'm using embossing powder. I have some pins and needles, my Stazon ink cleaner. I have some palette knives, some paper clips, rubber bands, my brayer, my little Making Memories, I think. Yeah, hammer. Some E6000, and then my stapler. And these I don't use very often, actually. I need to probably clean those out, my little sprayers. And then some staples. So this I always have to have on my desk. I use all the time. Here I have my laptop. I put it up on this thing because it was overheating sitting on my desk. It hasn't overheated since I did that. So underneath I have some albums I'm working on. I watch a lot of Netflix when I'm working on a project. So I always have my computer right here. There's a project that I made for Wild Orchid Crafts. I have some layouts up there. Those have flowers in them. I've got those jars from Michael's a long time ago. I love those jars. And then down underneath here, I have some baby wipes. That container there holds a bunch of dyes, pre-cut flourishes and leaves. I have my Big Bite here. This is just a random catch-all when I'm working on a project. I have my Fiskars stamp press, easy to grab right here. This little container here, I have, here's some push pins, but I keep pearls and gemstones in here, some bling. This one here I have, it's getting caught. I need to adjust that, but I have some rhinestones, things like that. And then this bottom one, I have some enamel dots. In this cabinet here, I have some watercolor pencils and coloring pencils, some bling, some extra wet glue, Q-tips, my Tim Holtz distress markers. I have some crochet twine, and behind that I have one of these little, I think I got this from TJ Maxx, a little container that I have some metal embellishments, some Tim Holtz hitch fasteners and flowers and clocks. Up there I have my clear embossing powder. Here I have glitter embossing powder and thick embossing powder in these containers. I have some extra enamel dots. And then I have some water bottles, spray bottles in the back there. On here's the front of my desk. And here is my very high-tech way of putting my camera so it faces directly where I'm working. It's just simply a tripod, and I needed something to weigh the side of it down to hold it down. So I just have a Bath & Body Works bag with a bunch of magazines in it, which works brilliantly. It's not pretty to look at, but it's where I keep my camera. It's easy, and like I said, it looks directly over my workstation. So in front of me, I keep a dresser that I altered for Saw Crafters. I absolutely love this. It holds a lot of her wooden embellishments, so it's easy to grab through. Sorry about the, let me turn the light on here. It's easy to just kind of grab through and go through these. This is a great storage unit if you're looking for little embellishments, and it's pretty to look at as well. So on the side here, again, not pretty to look at, but I had my husband just put a screw right in there, and I can keep my double-sided tape off my desk when I'm working, so it doesn't get buried under anything. I don't lose it. And at the top here, I have some little containers. Here is like some extra empty gift cards that I use for using modeling paste, things like that. I have some erasers, some popsicle sticks. This is where I keep my needle nose pliers, my binder, clippers, some screwdriver. Here I have some extra blades and some Gorilla tape. And then at the top I keep some acrylic blocks and my powder tool. Extra glue sticks. I don't use this size actually too much anymore. And then on this one I have some little handmade stamps. Some scissors, post-it notes. Here's my post-it notes, and then some sketch pens for the cameo. And then same with, in this one I have some pen holder things for the cameo. Here's some notebooks that I grabbed for my Heartfelt Creations Deluxe Flower Shaping Kit that I tend to grab for. Up here I have a stamp that says Corene's Creations. I keep my chapstick and my gum up here. I have my enamel dots that I just spilled. I have my bone folder, my scotch tape, and then this dresser here, again, probably hard to see, but this dresser is a dresser I altered also for Saw Crafter, and I love it. I keep my binder rings in here, and then some magnets up at the top. This container here, I keep my pens. Some wire, and then some magnets. I like to keep my envelope punch board right here. It's easy to grab. And then this beautiful box that my stepmother gave me is a bunch of Heidi Swap stamps in them. On the front of my desk, I sit in front of a window, but it's only a small view. I don't even have a great view, but I'm still grateful to have it. I have my tissues. I have a little lunchbox that I altered that I keep hard candies in, which is great. It brings my son and my husband in here quite often. And then this here I use all the time. This container I got from Tuesday Morning, I have my clips on it. I have my brushes that I use for Mod Podge or painting. I have my Wink of Stella. Here and here. I keep my Fabri-Tac in here, my other bone folder, my scissors, my hot glue sticks, and then my heat gun. So I'm always reaching for this. And then on the side here, again, not pretty to look at, but I think these are used for like brooms in your garage. My husband hung one for me, and it holds my ATG perfectly. So again, it takes up a lot of room, so it keeps it off my desk while I'm working. And then I always have my hot glue gun right there. Now I have enamel dots everywhere. Under my desk, I have a step stool just because I'm very short. I have all those cords, again, not pretty to look at, but they do the job. And I always keep my Martha Stewart scoreboard right there, easy to grab. And then on this side, I have that. I don't know who that is made by, but I got it at Michael's probably 15 years ago. And I use that all the time. I have a water bottle, my paper towels, and a full-size trash can, which is perfect because I sit right here. I'm able to just toss things into it. And let me give you a peek inside of these shelving units. I keep my Cricut and Cameo mats up there along with an extra craft mat, easy to get to. So here is what I keep in these. It's my stamping stuff. The first three are my stamping stuff. So the very first one, I keep my Hero Arts, my Distress Inks, my ink blending tools, some extra stamp blocks, my Stazon, my white, my Memento, things I use more often. And they're also labeled as well. Then the next one down are my odds and ends inks that maybe I don't use quite as often. I have my Spellbinder Celebrations, and then these are just all random ink pads. I have a couple extra Versamark in there, and then one of these multi-colored color box ones. And then the third one down is where I keep my embossing powders and my Perfect Pearls over here. I have my extra thick embossing powders, my white embossing powder, and I have an embossing buddy tray, my Stazon, my glue pad, a couple extra acrylic blocks, and then a stamp cleaner down there. And then the next one down is a container that I keep. These are these Petaloo flowers came in these. They're little drawers, and they had like an acetate window to them. I took that out, and I use these to keep cameo cuts separated. So when I'm working on a project and I have extra cuts, I toss them in here because I use them for other projects. And when I'm just doing a random project, I will a lot of times go through here and see what I can use for that. The other two that are down there, one I use for to hold clay making material, and the bottom one has a project that I'm working on in it. So those just sit in there. And one thing that I can suggest, if you have a smaller room, I'm happy with the size of my room, but I have a lot of furniture in it and then those baskets in it, so it's not a ton of floor space. But what I do that helps me is keep my room clean and as organized as I can keep it. Like, I did not clean for my room tour. This is how my room looks. Of course, if I'm in the middle of a project, it looks like a tornado went off in here, but I am in the middle of a project, and before I went to bed last night, I always clean up my room like this because I like to start my day with a fresh, clean start. I put all my tools away, even if I'm in the middle of working on a project. I don't like to walk into the room and feel overwhelmed with a huge mess. So even though I'm going to work on that today, this is how I like to start out before working on a project. So if that's one thing I can recommend, that's what I would do. So in this cabinet here, I have at the top, it's actually pretty deep, so I have like makeup sponges and things way in the back. I have some Bic markers, some Spectrum Noir pencil crayons, my chameleon markers here. I have these new water markers. I have not had a chance to play with. I'm so excited to play with those. And then I have some chalk markers here. Over here I have some extra chipboard, a clipboard that I use when heating stuff up, an extra paper trimmer. These daisy cups I get from Walmart, I use for when I apply Mod Podge or acrylic paints. In these drawers I have some bamboo sticks, I have some nail files when I'm working with chipboard, some nail buffers, extra cutting mats, watercolors. This, I have some adhesive sheets and then Velcro. And then down here I have some sequins and my roller stamp for my Smashbook. Down here is just kind of random stuff that I don't use quite as often, except for this container. That's all my Smashbook stuff, things I want to save, movie tickets, things like that. I throw in one of those, and then when I'm ready to Smashbook, I pull that out depending on what pictures I'm going to use. And then in these are my laminating stuff, some extra rulers. These are exactly what it says, stickers, rub-ons. I have some doilies in there, and I have a lot of like vellum stickers. These are holiday stuff. I have Halloween and Christmas, just stickers, some papers. I try and keep it all in there so it's easy to grab for. And then this, I have some foam, some shrink-a-dink, and I don't know what this is. Oh, some extra album insert pages. And then down here, I love this drawer, which I'll show you in just a moment. I do want to show you this, something that I love as part of it being a computer desk, is this rolls out, and I keep my Fiskars trimmer right here so I can put it right up on my desk, or a lot of times I just cut my paper right from here. And then I have an extra little cutting mat if need be, and then my two inks, my VersaFine Black Onyx, and then my Versamark. Those are the two I use the most. So back to this drawer right here. This is where I keep my most used papers. So I have my Georgia-Pacific white, so I use that for a lot of printing stuff. I have my Nina black, my craft, and then my Nina white. And then back there are thin pieces of chipboard, lightweight chipboard. Sorry, I'm trying to go really slow. Over here I was thinking of vertical storage for my ribbons, and I came up with this idea. My husband helped me make it, and it's just three rods. You can probably only see two right now, and that's where I keep most of my ribbons. So it's just easy. If I need one on the bottom, I just slide them off. There's a third one right over there, and it goes all the way down there. So it's a great way to not take up a lot of space. But I use that all the time. I keep my less used ones, like Christmas ones, things like that, at the bottom. And actually, I have a bin out in the garage for Christmas ribbons, but these can be used for both, usually. Under there, I have a sewing box that was my mother-in-law's. A lot of stuff, if I sew, that I go to that. And then there's also a container way in the back of some material, things like that, that I don't use very often. These two filing cabinets, I love these. My husband got these for me. They fit under that desk or that table. And the top one has my chipboard, which is extremely convenient because we're a little out of focus there. Which my cutter is right here above on the desk, which I'll show you in a moment. So that's very convenient. The next drawer is my office supply stuff. I have extra tape, ink, my Dymo label maker, my camera cords, some tags, and my external hard drive. And then down here I have stuff for albums. I have some blank calendars back there, and then I have some stencils, and I also have a Kaluzzle, one of the first tools that I bought, if you know what that is. Can't get rid of that. I do use that every now and then. On this side, this is where I keep my Misti. I have a bunch of photo paper back there. Also, this is a little lid. I have some more photo paper under here. The second drawer down is my cinch and all my wire rings. That fits nicely in here, mostly. And the last drawer, this is one of my favorites. This is where I keep all my scraps. So I have my white Georgia-Pacific scraps. I have my Nina scraps. It's not that pretty to look at. I've had this for a long time. But then I have them by color. So if I'm looking for, you know, a purple scrap, I can pull this file out and search through it, find a color that I can use before using a new piece of paper. And then I have solid 8.5 by 11. I have my red, my craft, black. I have gray and cream in there. And then I have some different color grays, and then blue, and then I have just miscellaneous ones as well. So that is housed down there. And then I have this large workstation where I keep my cutter. Over here I have a couple more dressers that I alter for Saw Crafter, and I do keep some embellishments in them. And they're really pretty to look at. On the top I have another one of these stands. In this I have a bunch of random flowers, a lot of homemade flowers. And then I have some pins and some clay cabochon flowers. Up here I have a shelf that my late brother-in-law made me. It's a gorgeous shelf. He also made me this as well a long time ago. It says, I don't know how well it'll pick it up, it says Corene Capricorn. Trying to go really slow. So I have that shelf. That is just some Christmas berries and sprays, things like that. And then the rest are just decorative. My sister made me that wooden plaque. I have these cute little bowls. I got these, I believe, from the dollar store. I use them for water when I'm painting or something. And then also to show you up here, it's not really pretty to look at, but my husband hung that for me. That puts so much light in this room. I love it. Feels like I'm in the dark without it on now. I'm so used to it. So I have some shelves just with things, projects I've made, layouts, things that are important. And then this here is my Carl trimmer. It's a rotary trimmer. Highly, highly recommend it. It cuts through about 4 sheets of cardstock at once, 3 of 110-pound cardstock, and medium-weight chipboard with no problem. Got that from Amazon. I keep my Sizzix Big Shot over here. And then this little turntable thing I got from Home Depot. I can't seem to find anymore, and I think I paid $12 for all of these. So there's 7 shelves, and this is great. It holds all my pearls. If there's a project I'm working on, this comes off, so I can just take this off and take it over to my desk. So I have random pearls and some Tim Holtz and then some spare parts, some Graphic 45 door plates and knobs. I have some metal keys, some of the Tim Holtz frames. I have a bunch of rhinestones and more pearls. My binder clips, metal embellishments, some acrylic pieces. And then at the bottom, just random items. This one doesn't turn, so I put my less used items down there, and then I just slide this back when I'm not using it. So last but not least, I have this shelf over here, along with this, I believe it's a Making Memories shelf there. I have some extra flowers up there. And then this here is another basket that matches that basket right up there. I keep some random trims, my seam binding, lace, no, there's no lace in there, but just trims and hemp twine, things like that. My dog loves to come in here and steal stuff and run out with it, so a lot of times I have to keep it up here on the desk. And in this cabinet here, I have chipboard. So I try and use any of this chipboard up before I happen to cut a new piece. That whole drawer is chipboard. This are little chipboard books, mini albums, altered items, alterable items. I have some acrylic mini albums in there too. And then this one I keep my cutting plates, some extra glitter, and then a lot of the Graphic 45 staples tags. Some 7 gypsies. And lastly, I keep my extended plate right here. Lastly, I have this cabinet. At the top there, I have some shipping supply stuff. I have some tapes, duct tape, things like that. And then the rest is vinyl. I have all different types of vinyl. I have some transfer paper. I have some gift bags in the back there, some extra clipboards, and then that right there, that container, is where I keep my handmade cards. So it's easy to just kind of go in and grab to find one. So that's my entire room. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope it's not been too fast or too shaky. And thanks so much for watching.